As a young child, Joe dreamt of being an Olympic gymnast. But by high school, the pressure to be perfect drove him to drink.
You know, it's like when religious people say, the gates of heaven opened up. This was my gates of heaven. This was my religion. This was, and I knew then it was drinking. This was going to solve all my problems.
By the time he entered college, he was out of control.
I was drinking and using prescription drugs and a lot of cocaine.
And soon enough, heroin. Joe wrote about his struggles in the very raw and emotional memoir called Acrobaddict. It's a book worth reading. I've read it myself, and he joins us now. Thank you. How are you doing, first of all? We've talked several times over the past couple of years. How are you feeling?
Good. Good, actually, yep.
Healing up well. You're back to your training routines and all of that. You shared with me the first time we spoke, I mean, just how many substances have been a part of your life. I mean, you've been addicted to many different substances, but it was heroin in particular that really did you in, as you say.
Yes.
What is it about heroin? Is there a way to describe what it feels like?
Yes, for me, I definitely felt like I was on fire. I was euphoric. I felt safe. I felt loved and in unity. It was almost like I didn't need life because I had this other substance that that brought it to me.
It's amazing because I've talked to people who are addicts over the years, and they all describe that warm, safe feeling.
Yeah.
And that's a very, very desirable feeling. What was the turning point for you to start getting away from it?
The turning point it happened right away, actually. You know, my addiction was very textbook. I was sniffing it for 2 years, and then I started becoming an intravenous drug addict. And I knew I had to stop because I I became physically addicted quickly. What a lot of addicts or people who are just coming to use heroin or other opiates don't think they're gonna be physically dependent so quickly, and that's the lie. We actually become physically sick quicker than we imagine.
What did that feel? So if you stopped taking it, you would feel sick.
Yeah.
Can you describe that?
It was horrible. It was like one of the worst flus I've ever had. The most difficult aspect was you can't really take cold medicine to feel better. You know inside of you that there's one thing out there that's going to make this go away. Now, the problem we seem to have is that we have jobs and stuff we have to go to. You can't be dope sick and go to work. So it creates this vicious cycle that you have to use in order to be a part of life again.
So you were worse off functionally if you weren't using than when you were.
Absolutely.
So just pragmatically, it's crazy. When you hear about Philip Seymour Hoffman, he was clean, he says, for in a long time, maybe 20 years, and then relapsed.
Yeah.
Did that surprise you, and does it make you worry about yourself even?
It didn't surprise me. It's extremely heartbreaking, and this happens every day, actually. Because we have a chronic, fatal, and progressive disease, which we've been trying to, addicts in recovery have been trying to explain that for a long time. People are always asking me, do you have to be vigilant, even after almost 7 years? And the answer is yes. It is chronic, so, you know, like diabetes, it has to be treated every day. Something I like to say is yesterday's shower won't keep me clean. So every day I wake up with my disease and I have to treat it. And yes, I am fearful.
Treating it means being very vigilant.
Yeah.
And to point out, and I was very interested in this as a doctor, but you had surgery for which a lot of people would have taken pain medications, either IV or oral pain medications afterwards. You couldn't do that.
Right.
If you had taken a Percocet or something for this invasive surgery, what were you worried about?
Well, I was worried that even though I may have not become physically dependent because the duration of the use would have been shortened, that it would create the desire to use or the obsession. What a lot of non-addicted people don't understand is that addiction, we have this obsession that's almost otherworldly. It's depressing and it's all you can think about. So having taken an opiate to relieve my pain, it would have made me right back on the track, and I've seen this happen so many times.
You were talking about that. I mean, people that you know who go for an operation, get a dose of Dilaudid after the surgery, which is pretty routine, and suddenly the beast has been awakened.
Yep.
It's a scary thing. I'm glad you're well. And I
me
mean,
too.
We hear about these stories when things don't go well, Philip Seymour Hoffman. So we wanted to share your story, and hopefully it serves as inspiration to a lot of people. You've inspired a lot of people, by the way, through your book and being on the show before, so I appreciate that.
Thank you.